Hello friend, welcome to Salesforce tutorial. I'm Prajakta from Paragit Technology. In our previous video, we moved to a little bit development part of Salesforce, like how to create a visual force page and what is the difference between standard controller and the custom controller. Today we are going to see how to use a static resource on visual force page, or we can say that what is the use of static resource actually. Okay, so go to the search box and type static resources. So under the develop section you can find the static resources link and click on it. So click on the new button and here you can store the static resource. Now static resource allow you to upload a content that you can reference on a visual force page. So which kind of file you can store in static resource? You can store the zip file, .rar file, also you can store the images, style sheet, JavaScript file. Okay, so I want to create one visual force page, and through that visual force page I am going to insert one record into the account object. So when user click on the save button, I want to show a processing image, or we can say that loading image. Okay, so I will create the static resource for the loading image. So make sure that image you have to store in your local machine first. So give the name. So I will give the name as a demo image, or we can say that, yeah, image loading, this name I will give, and choose the file from your local machine. So loading GFT, this is what the image name, and I will say the cache control as a public and say save. So here your static resource for the loading images get created. Now if you click on the view file, you can see the image here. So okay, so go to the search box and type pages to create a visual force page and click on it. So I will say the new visual force page and give the name to your visual force page. So I will give the name as a account record, as I want to store the account. Okay, and I will cancel this code, and here I will write our code. So Apex form, I will take Apex page block, and in the Apex page block I will take Apex page block section. Okay, so if you want to insert the account, we want the standard field that is mandatory, which is the account name. So I will take the Apex input field, and the value of the, okay, so for that we have to take a standard controller, and the standard name of the standard controller will be the account, as we want to store the account. So here we can see the object dot the field name. So this is the account object and the name of the field. So here I will use the action status to show the image on the command button. So I think I have already written the So this is what the code I have already written, and I will just paste it here. So what I have done here, I will let you know. Okay, so I have used the action status, and we all know that action status display the status of an AJAX request. Okay, so in the action status I have used a facet start and a facet of stop. So in the stop I have used the command button. So we all know the syntax of writing the Apex command button attribute. As we have taken a standard controller, so we have used, or I can use the standard save method for the storing the record, or we can say for the save the record. So I have taken a status as a show processing, which is the ID of the action status, and I'm going to re-render my command button after clicking to the action status, and the ID I have passed to the re-render, and this is what the syntax of showing the image. So now this is what the syntax and URL I have given the name of the image that we just have created in the static resources. So what is the URL for? URL for is a function to reference a particular file in a static resources, and the resources is used to reference an existing static resources. So this is what the syntax. If you are facing the syntax, so go to the component reference, and here you can find all the syntax. So I will go to the Apex images, okay, and go to the uses. So here you can find this is the way of writing the component Apex images. So in the URL section, you can give the path of the image that you have just created in your static resources. Okay, so I have created this page and I'm now going to save the page. So click on the preview button to run the page. Here I will insert one account. The name of the account is demo account, and now when I click on the save button, you can see the processing image after clicking on the save button, okay, and our demo account record is get inserted. So it is very simple. So if you want to show the image, this is what the way you can write. And if you want to, you know, write the JavaScript or want to show the JavaScript on Visual Force page, then how you will use. So go to the component reference and I will tell you the attribute that is get use, and the name of the attribute is Apex include script. So go to the uses, and here you can find this is what the way when you stored your JavaScript. So this is example underscore js is the name of the file, and in that file there is one file of the code of the JS, and that is stored into the static resources. Okay, so this is very simple. So thank you for watching this video, guys. To know about us, you can visit www.paraguide.com www.paraguide.com. okay, so thank you guys, bye bye.